A very good morning, dear children. Hope you all had a very happy Baisakhi. Wish you all and your family members a happy and prosperous Baisakhi. Today, we are here to discuss a poem based on another festival which is celebrated in India, that is Rakhi. This poem is written by the famous poet and novelist Vikram Seth. Vikram Seth is an Indian novelist and poet. He has written several novels and poetry books. He has received several awards such as Padma Shri, Sahitya Academy Award, Pravasi Bhartiya Samman, W.H. Smith Literary Award and Crossword Book Award. Seth's collections of poetry such as Mappings and Beastly Tales are notable contributions to the Indian English language poetry canon. Sibling relationships and family are recurring themes in his poetry. So, Vikram Seth has basically written poetry based on the theme of sibling relationships and family. This poem, from the name Rakhi itself, you can understand that this poem is also based on such a theme. Meaning. Now, what do we mean by Raksha Bandhan? Rakhi or Raksha Bandhan is a ceremony in which the sister ties a band of thread, which we call as Rakhi, around the wrist of her brother. Okay? What do we mean by Raksha Bandhan? From the name itself, it implies that Raksha means to protect and Bandhan is bond. So it's a bonding between the brother and the sister for of what? Of protection, of love, of happiness and everything. So Raksha Bandhan represents the strong, undying bond between siblings. Now we come to the poem. What has Vikram Seth written in this poem? In this poem, the poet realizes that certain things do not change despite the passage of time. So, when we will read the poem line by line, we will understand, we'll see that Vikram Seth has emphasized on one thing, that with the passage of time, people change, their physical appearance change, their nature also at times change, but certain things do not change. They stay the same. And what are these things? These things are the old traditions that is being forwarded from generation to generation. Clear? So in this poem, the poet realizes that certain things do not change despite the passage of time. They stay the same. After all, the Rakhi is a contract of trust between the siblings. So what is Rakhi? Rakhi is basically a contract of trust, a contract of protection, love, trust between the brother and the sister. He struggles to tie the thread with his left hand. Now when we will read the poem, we will see that he is writing the poem at a time when he is far off from his sister. His sister was not present over there when he was trying to tie the Rakhi around his wrist. And because he was doing it himself, he was struggling to tie the Rakhi around the wrist by himself. Okay? He struggles to tie the thread with his left hand and laments that he has forgotten half the sacred rites. Now, what do we mean by half the sacred rites? Here we mean how the sacred rite means. When you tie the rakhi around your brother's wrist, what your brother does? Your brother gives you a gift, right? So that is another ritual, another rite which is to be followed by your brother. So here, because Vikram Seth is not present with his sister, so his sister is unable to tie the rakhi by her own, right? So this is half of the rite which his sister is unable to perform, and half of his rite, which means that he will be giving the gift to his sister, that also he has forgotten. That is what he is mentioning here as half of the sacred rites. He also promises his sister to hand over the gift to her by 1978. So he takes a year, he thinks about a year, he mentions here about a year where he wishes to meet his sister again in order to give the gift to her. He tells her not to be surprised if they meet as strangers when they next see each other, because we all know, children, with passage of time we all change. Our physical appearances change, our nature changes, many things changes, right? So here Vikram Seth is saying the same thing to his sister, that do not be surprised that too if we meet as strangers after so many years. We'll have so many new things to discuss, so many new things to talk with each other, share with each other. So we will meet as strangers. However changed both of them are. So now the poet is also saying that it doesn't matter how much changed we both are, but I am thankful to one thing. He is thankful that the customs will remain the same. So he is thankful that at least the customs will remain the same, which are being brought from passed on from generation to generation, to bond, to keep the bond intact between the siblings, between the family. However changed both of them are, he is thankful that the customs will stay the same, bringing from the past the undying days of settled tradition. Undying days means the days which can never die. So the undying days of settled traditions they have come to depend upon. So they have depended upon these days, these undying traditions that are being passed generation after generation. Clear? So what theme we can get from this poem? What is the basic theme of this poem? Raksha Bandhan, a Hindu festival, signifies emotions, everlasting love and eternal bonding between brother and sister. This we all know, right? It is a bonding. It signifies a bonding, an eternal bonding between the brother and the sister. On this day, sisters tie rakhi on the wrists of their brothers to protect them against evil influences and pray for their long life and happiness. Okay, so the sister ties the rakhi around the wrist of the brother and what? And prays for their long life and happiness. Clear? They in turn, they means over here the brothers, they in turn give a gift which is a promise that they will protect their sisters from any harm. So the brothers also in return, what do? They also promise to protect their sisters from any harm. That is raksha. Raksha means protection. Within these rakhis reside sacred feelings and well wishes. So these rakhis are just not merely some a band of thread, but inside it resides feelings, deep bondings, and well wishes between the siblings. The theme of this poem also hovers round these feelings. The poet, despite being far from his sister, wishes that his sister could fulfill the rites. Which rite? The rite of tying the rakhi around her brother's wrist by herself. And in return, he could have given her the gift, which is a promise from his side to protect her throughout her life. So he wishes that his sister could have been present there to tie the rakhi around his wrist, and in return he could have fulfilled by giving the gift to her. Okay? He also thanks the prevailing customs and traditions, as they will remain the same, bringing them closer year after year. So only these customs and traditions will help keep the bonding intact year after year. Okay?